This is the inside story of your bones and muscles, the team that hustles. And here to tell you about it is the one and only Slim Goodbody.
When I want to move, when I want to move, I tell my muscles to get moving on. And when I'm listening to some rhythms and I'm wishing to dance with them, my bones and muscles keep me grooving, grooving. When I hear the band start playing, my muscles start to hustle without delay, and they pull my bones, they get me swaying. It's great teamwork they're displaying, and in this show we'll be relaying information which will have you saying, my bones and muscles are fine, I'm glad I've got mine. One of the great partnerships at work in your body is between your bones and your muscles. They team up to give you shape, motion, and protection. Why, without your bones and muscles, your life would be in danger every time you knocked into something. They guard your soft, sensitive inner parts, and movement would be impossible without your bones and your muscles to pull them around. If you've ever seen a house going up, you know that a frame must be put up first to give support to the rest of the building. Or think of a tent. The tent poles are like bones. Your skeleton, another name for your bones, is the framework of your body. It gives you your basic shape and size, and along with muscles, it allows you to do quite a lot of things. It's the same with animals. Their skeleton determines the way they look and how they behave. Think of all the different things animals can do. Would your skeleton and muscles allow you to do any of these? Well, your body can do certain things that animals can't do. Because of bones and muscles, you look as you do, and you're able to do the things you want to. Yeah! Everyone's skeleton works basically the same way. Why? Because babies are born with the same skeletal design as their parents. As they grow older, their bones get bigger, but not really different, except drier and more brittle.
I beg your pardon?
Who said that?
This collection of old dry bones, that's who.
Well, excuse me, I didn't mean to offend you.
No matter. Nobody cares about me anyway. With my body gone, I'm useless.
No, that's not true. Why, I bet you'd make a great teacher. Together, we could explain an awful lot about bones. What do you say?
Well, I'm kind of stiff, but I'll give it a try.
One is connected to two, is connected to 27 bones in your wrist and hand.
One is connected to two, is connected to 26 bones in your ankle and foot.
Your feet are on the ground,
head in the sky.
Your bones are great, and we'll tell you why. They help keep you straight, they support your weight. They're your bones,
your fabulous bones. Ribs go around your chest, dressed in a bony vest with a striped design.
You see, your ribs are connected in the front to the sternum and in the back to the spine. Head in the sky, feet on the ground. Put your hands on your ribs right now and move them around. You've got 12 ribs on this side, 12 ribs on this side, guarding your soft insides. And the bones of your cranium
protect your brainium. Slim, why are the two bottom pairs of ribs, which aren't connected to the sternum, like boats?
Oh, you mean these two bottom ribs here? Why are the two bottom pair of ribs like boats?
Because they're floating ribs.
Speaking about boats, did you know that a bone is made partly of water, almost half is made of minerals like calcium and phosphorus, and the rest is protein?
And bones are light and lean. Do you know, Slim, that you're 5 times heavier than I am?
You're lighter than I am because bones aren't solid all the way through. They have different layers. A hard outer layer called compact bone, but inside there's spongy bone. Now, it's called spongy not because it's soft, but because it's got a lot of different holes in it. This gives it strength without adding weight. On a weight-for-weight basis, bones are stronger than steel.
Don't mess with me.
And they're very busy. Millions of living cells need food and oxygen, and thousands of blood vessels supply it. Some bones even make blood cells in the bone marrow. So now you found out about
why you can't do without
your strong and wonderful bones. Without your skeleton, your body would be like gelatin.
One, two, three, four.
One, two, three, four?
That's right. One, two, three, four different kinds of bones.
Oh, I see what you mean. Long bones found in your arms and your legs. Short bones found at your wrist and your ankles. Flat bones found at your ribs and your skull. And irregular bones found in your spine.
By the way, Slim, I heard one of my bones complaining to another one of my bones.
And what was that bone saying to the other bone?
Why don't we go to a nice restaurant instead of meeting at a joint like this?
Ugh.
206 different bones in my body.
Where two bones come together, we call that a joint. Now some joints are for bending, and some are for rotation.
While others barely move at all, or ever change location.
So you know the point of a joint. I repeat, the joint's a point where two bones meet. Now everybody in your seat, point to a joint. Now everyone hold your arm out. Imagine your arm only had one bone. You couldn't bend it. But your arm has more than one bone, so you can bend and move. The place where bones meet are called joints. Here's a joint. It's found at your shoulder and your hips. It's called a ball and socket joint. It's like a ball in a socket. It gives you maximum flexibility. Another joint is called the hinge joint, found at your fingers, toes, knees, and elbows. It opens and closes back and forth like a door on a hinge. Good. Now everybody use your fingertip and point to a joint. Thank you, skeleton.
Without a joint, you couldn't point. You're welcome, Slim.
And that's the point of a joint. Skeleton, you were wonderful. And your skeleton is wonderful, too. But now, it's time to meet another member of the team that hustles. Your mussels. Mussels have the important job of moving bones. As a matter of fact, bones can't do their work unless mussels do theirs. Now look at these machines. Which parts of them are like bones? Which parts are like mussels? Can you see the joints in them too? But your body is much more wonderful than any machine. You're growing and changing each day that you live, feeling the pleasure that movement can give. With strength and precision, you reach for your goal. You make the decisions, and you're in control. Bending and flowing with style and with grace, beautifully moving your body through space. Such freedom of motion. You're having a ball. Oh, the incredible joy of it all. Place your hand on your bicep and bend your arm. Feel something changing shape? Good. Now relax your arm. Feel a change again? What's changing shape underneath your skin? That's right, your muscles. You've got over 600 different muscles working together in your body, 30 in your face alone. Now, when your brain sends a message, these muscles move. They're called voluntary muscles because they're under your conscious control. But there are other types of muscles in your body, too. Take an imaginary piece of food out of the air, put it in your mouth, chew it up, and swallow it. While you're chewing, you're using voluntary muscles. But after you swallow, the food is pushed along the digestive tract by involuntary muscles. There are even involuntary muscles attached to the hairs in your skin, which causes them to stand up on end when you're scared or cold. Now, the hardest working muscle in your body is, that's right, the heart. The heart beats without us telling it to. That's because it's made of a special muscle called the cardiac muscle. Even though we can't control the cardiac muscle, our hearts will speed up during exercise in order to supply the rest of our muscles with the blood and energy they need. When you exercise, you're not only keeping your voluntary muscles in shape, but you're also causing your heart to beat faster and exercise too. Exercise is not only good for you, but it's fun, and it makes you feel a whole lot better. Just like everything else in your body, your muscles are made of living cells. And if you could see muscle cells magnified many times, they would look something like this. Each cell in a muscle works just like the whole muscle. Remember how you felt your bicep changing shape? When all the cells work together, the whole muscle works. And when muscles work together, your arm moves, your leg moves, or whatever you want to move, moves. When they move a bone, when your muscles move a bone, one muscle is contracting. It's getting shorter, tauter, tighter, but it never works alone. No, 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 no. Another muscle's relaxing. Muscles work in pairs. And you've got more than 600 of them covering your skeleton. They make up almost half your weight and help to keep you standing straight. With sleep, good food, and exercise, they'll keep a healthy shape and size. Your muscles love to move and do the muscle hustle. Oh, yeah. Bones and muscles, the team that hustles. Let's see how they work together in the hand. Do you realize that more than a quarter of the bones in your whole body are in your hands alone? Let's see how it all works. Your brain sends a message to the muscles of your lower arm and causes them to contract or tighten. This pulls on tendons, which are like cords attached to the bones of your finger. This causes your finger to move. Then tendons and muscles on the other side of your hand pull the bone back. Tendons connect your muscles to your bones. Ligaments bind your bones together. You know, it's interesting to note that muscles usually work in pairs. One muscle pulls the bone this way, and one muscle pulls the bone back. Now, just for fun, open up your hand, relax your fingers. Now, if you press on your tendon in your lower arm, it will cause your fingers to curl. Go ahead, press. Good, relax. Do it again. See? Now, your hands are the greatest tools in the world. Your hands out. Dangling down at the end of your arms are a couple of helping hands. Hands are great for making friends, so shake hands with a person sitting next to you. Good. Now stop, put your hands in front of you, and do this with me. Your hands pick up, put down, push, pull, peel cucumbers, clutch, touch, dial your best friend's telephone number, dig a ditch, catch a fish, you can even scratch an itch with your helping hands. And what would music be like without hands? Get yourself an imaginary guitar and do some strumming. All right, now play the flute. Do 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 do. Bass, drums. Okay, now everybody look at your hands. They help you every day in a thousand ways. Everybody say thank you, hands. Muscles in your palm and in your lower arm pull on the tendons which control your finger movements. Now these tendons can be felt. Just clench your fingers like a claw and you'll feel them for sure. Feel them now. Okay. I'm sure that you all realize we need good food and exercise to keep us feeling strong and fit. It's your body. Take care of it.